Hello, this is Juan number 8, which is chapter 7. On chapter 7, we learn about momentum, we learn about impulse, we learn about conservations of momentum and collisions, and we learn about center of mass. Let's go through the homework problems. This should be a relatively straightforward homework, so I want all of you to try to get as many points as possible in it. Question number 1 is a question of an impulse, and an impulse is the product of the force times the time that the force acts on it, and according to Newton's law, that is equal to the change in momentum. And the change in momentum is the final momentum minus the initial momentum. So it's all of these things happen in a line. This is the signs indicate the direction. So this will be the mass of the object times its final velocity, minus the mass of the object times its initial velocity. If the object is at rest, like in this example, this is zero. So by knowing the impulse, you can calculate the final velocity. In number two, you have the problem of bouncing back. So when an object bounces back, the change in momentum of the object, which is its final momentum minus its initial momentum, is equal to, in magnitude, is equal to twice the mass of the object times the velocity. The reason is because the change in momentum, if this is the positive direction, and then the object bounces back in this direction, then the final momentum is that, the initial momentum is this, and the change is minus 2mv in that direction. Number 3 was done in lecture on Friday, is the problem of the rifle. The initial momentum is 0. The momentum of the bullet is this, and the momentum of the rifle, it will be that. So, if this is this recoil speed, you can solve for the recoil speed with this equation. Problem number 4 is an interesting problem, is a comprehensive problem, because it involves conservation of energy, conservation of momentum, and also projectiles. So the situation is as follows. You have a skier that is come down without friction up to this point. So here is the skier, come with no friction, then picks up this backpack here and then becomes a projectile. So the problem has 3 parts. From here, there is a height here. So if it starts from rest and there is no friction, then there is a potential energy here that it gets converted into a kinetic energy here. So you will know the velocity that it will have there. Then it picks up the backpack. So when it picks up the backpack, it becomes a collision. So if the initial momentum is that, the final momentum is the mass of the skier plus the mass of the backpack times the speed that they are going to have when they go together right here. Right here, they become a projectile, and what you need to calculate is the range, which is the distance that is going to travel, which is this velocity times the time, remember projectiles, and the time is the same time that it will come down from that height. Number 5 is conservation of momentum. You have to conserve momentum in both directions. In this particular case, what is important is the x direction, because when the you have the cannon, and the bullet is going to go off the cannon. And if this angle is 60 degrees, then you have a nice picture that shows you the railroad car. So the railroad car, which is here, is going to recoil in that direction. So therefore, the momentum in the x direction of the cannon of the shell has to be equal to the momentum in the x direction of the car. So from here, you will get the velocity of the car. And this is, of course, they give you this velocity and they give you this mass. So the momentum of the shell is mv cosine 60. Number six is a problem about the center of mass. And in number six, for center of mass, you always have to have an axis. So you have to have an x-axis and a y-axis. So if one particle is here at the origin, and then tell you that the center of mass is, let's say, here. So they give you these numbers. They give you these, and they give you that. And if this is A, where B has to be in order for the center of mass to be there? Well, x center of mass is nothing more than the mass of A, where A is, plus the mass of B, where this is, divided by the sum of the masses. And this is the other equation for the vertical component of the center of mass. So what I know is that A is at the origin, so this is zero, and this is zero. And I know that, and I know that, so I can solve for that, and I can solve for that. Don't forget these factors here. If we go to number seven and number eight, they are also applications of this equation. And number eight is the velocity of the center of mass. So the velocity of the center of mass is mass one times the velocity of mass one times mass two, the velocity of mass two divided by the sum of the masses, for example. Number nine is a collision problem again, in which you have a bullet that comes and hits a piece of wood, and then the piece of wood travels a certain distance until it stops. And you want to know this velocity. Well, this velocity, you know it if you know the velocity when it's come here. By conservation of momentum, you can calculate the final velocity of the bullet plus the wood. And if you know the distance that travels, you know the work done by friction will be that. And that will be the change in kinetic energy, which will be that. So, and then you can go back and get and get the initial velocity. And number 10 is an application of the equations that we deduce in lecture, in which we solve the problem for a mass m1 coming in here when a mass m2 is at rest, and the final velocity of one is the difference in the sums times this, and this is an application directly of these equations. So